Welcome to a new video from EU Droneport. In late October 2023, EASA, European Union Aviation Safety Agency, unveiled a fresh iteration of acceptable means of compliance and guidance material that have an impact on regulations 2019/904/5 and 2019/904/7. Within this video, we shall delve into several significant alterations outlined in the recently released decision 2023/012/R by EASA. Let's keep in mind that when you're doing a risk analysis using the SORA methodology, you've got to tailor your requirements to match the complexity of your situation. One of these requirements deals with the aircraft's design, and initially, it needed to pass a safety test just like with regular airplanes, either getting a type certificate, TC, or a restricted type certificate, RTC. But those certificates seemed like overkill, so EASA came up with a more balanced option for unmanned aircraft systems, UAS. The Design Verification Report, DVR. You'd only need the DVR when the risk was considered moderate, resulting in a SAIL 3 or 2 rating. The TC and RTCs were kept for the high-risk situations. After 2 years of drone flights in Europe and thousands of flights without major accidents, you'd only need the DVR for operations with a SAIL 4 rating. For lower SAIL values, each EU member state's authorities might just accept the operator's word, and if they have doubts, they could ask for more proof. PDRA S-01 is pretty much like the standard scenario STS-01, but the cool thing is you don't need a drone with a fancy C5 class label for it. And guess what? They tweaked it to also cover those fun flights where you're spraying phytosanitary products in agriculture. Here's the lowdown on the changes they've made. The 25 kilogram limit for the UAS has been removed. That 25 kilogram weight limit for your drone, poof, it's gone, as long as it's not more than 3 meters in size. Compliance with Directive 2009/128/EC. They're making sure you play by the rules of Directive 2009/128/EC. Proper definition of the locations where the operations will take place. You'll need to nail down exactly where you're going to be doing these operations. Addition of operations at a maximum altitude of 10 meters. You can now take your bird up to a maximum height of 10 meters. The need to define procedures for flying in controlled airspace. If you're flying in controlled airspace, they want you to have a game plan. And last, no requirement to use an enhanced containment system if the flight is conducted in areas where the adjacent area is considered low risk. This is the fun part. If you're cruising in areas with low risk surroundings, you don't have to bother with some fancy containment system. Thank you for joining us on this journey. For more information regarding EASA decision on PDRA S01, visit eudroneport.com or click the link in the description. Safe flights.